Okay, let's get into streaming some faff. I haven't played in a long time. Friends have suggested playing it recently, so I have to go back and learn all the things that I knew once again, and see where we are from there. Hopefully, I shouldn't suck too bad. I'm sure friends will tell me otherwise. So I'm going to play as Aeon, and against your computer with a teammate, just to get back into things. See how it all works, shall we say. I'm going to try a map called Fields of Isis. I'm going to be top left hand. And we'll launch this and see how we go. Hopefully. Like I said, I've remembered all the key stats and what I should be doing when I should be doing it. I'm sure people will point out, especially friends, that when I get it wrong. Inevitably I will be doing. For those who haven't played, it's a standard RTS. Base building, unit building, upgrading, all that malarkey. There's a little bit more to it than some standard RTSs, to be fair. And it's an older game as well, so it might not look as pretty as you would hope. So first thing we're doing is building our land factory, which produces units. And that land factory is going to require some power. In fact, what we won't do, we'll get our commander building some mass production, and mass production is the resource that is going to supply us with money to buy things. So then what we'll do is we'll get this little bot here to build me some power. And what you get is you get adjacency bonuses, so you can see where I have built my power next to the base, is because that's going to feed into here, producing, taking units less energy to produce. Two units on there, producing that quickly. computer can act a bit weird, so one of my commander rushes down here before the computer runs up and takes my mass on me. You can see I'm flashing power at the top here. I'm having a bit of a power crash moment at the moment. I should have jumped on the power a bit sooner maybe with my commander. It's all good. So these are scouts. Scouts give my units a bit more radar, and then I'll produce some tanks as well. That way I can defend myself, and my tanks will actually see a bit further forward as well. So what I'm going to get them to do is just build me a bit more power, just so I don't struggle for that. Commander's done. Excellent work. Just build two anti-air turrets, and then while he's done them, I'll get him to produce the other two mass at the back. In fact, what I'm going to do is just send that one over there, that engineer. Excellent. I'll start producing some units. Is fighting each other. So when they've done that, they're going to now go and produce my hydrocarbon, which is a small power generator. You can see the white lines feeding in here, so now we've got some adjacency bonuses going on. Units just feeding in from the enemy. It's all fine, it's all part of the master plan. Start upgrading our mechs. There's a few enemy field funneling in at the moment. So one thing I haven't done, which I should have done by now, which I'll correct very quickly in fact, is I should have built some radar. That will stop, that will let me see anybody that's coming in. Bring my units up. Okay, so game time is 5 minutes 17. Now, what I should be aiming for now is a Tech 2 land factory. The other thing I haven't done, which I'm going to do in a moment, is get some nice looking reclaim, because you can reclaim things like these big boulders here, and they will provide you with more mass. See how my mass is flashing at the top? So for example, this one here can finish reclaim. My computer's having a bit of a trouble at the bottom. I was gonna move then, and then you got the enemy stuck with him. After attack. This over here, because they're sending out lots of fallen troops. Reclaim. Reclaim is a very important secondary resource. Power. Got positive power again. Anti-air comes up because there are planes coming over constantly by blue. Now I'm on the attack, trying to slow the other economies down as the players. Defense up on the base. So now we're going to put mass storage around each of the mass points, because that then generates an extra 3 mass per pump. Busy working on some Tech 2 power, which will be really nice. That's really going to help me with production. Some units up. Stop them flying over as bad, getting as close to the base. As soon as the power goes up, I should be able to upgrade my radar as well to Tech 2. Having a bit of mass stall at the moment. Commander forward. This is something you won't want to do here. Some grids to do, still trying to produce my mass cooker, so I've got some radar upgraded as well. quite sustained tech 2 yet. I need a bit more power. These are getting an adjacency bonus, like I said. So this pump now is making me 9, as you can see at the bottom. It takes 9 energy, but is producing 9 mass, which is really good. So I'll watch that. Now I'm going to spam out some spy planes so I can find out now what the enemy's doing. Computer looks to have the advantage at the moment, has to be said. Shield or as would seem. Way. tech 3 now. In for the attack again, see if we can push them. Ramp it up to tech 3 mass. Slower than I would like, but at least it's coming on now. Right, so save the red now from being absolutely demolished from the bottom. I'm going to ride out and meet the grey at the top. Still upgrading my mechs. Let's produce four of them and then we'll upgrade to that. Just to circle this bit. So far, so good. We've got radar up, we've got to tech 2 consistently, we're moving to tech 3. Most of my mechs are upgraded. See by my mass count coming in that things are going good. I just need to nab one of these now and go and get some extra reclaim. Get a foothold back in them corners. All out war. Alright, so we had a power crash again. Numbers. I need to build me an extra power gen. That's one thing about Aeon is they are power hungry. This should help me going pulling it in some reclaim. Nearly done. And they've stopped producing, which is nice, so I'll let that build up. So if the units are going to be able to go to tech 3. It's a lot of point prints. Now sending all the units down towards me. Well and truly in there now. Commander's gonna go pop. Off on tech 3 power. Tech 3 power is the next thing we're building. Once Tech 3 power is upgrade our radar to Omri, which will allow us to see more of the map. Power first off. Their shields are telling to mass produce after that. Red's gonna win it for us anyway, it doesn't really matter. But these are now nice tech 3s coming out in force. Power's back to where it should be, mass is where it should be. From here on in now, it's just build what you want and win the game. It's tech 3 units are as hardy as anything. Ships, one of my favourite units. Commander under the shield. Becomes hardy as anything. Building something what's known as a RAS commander, what they do is they actually give you more mass and power per commander that's produced. Spit out a few more engineers just so I can build some more stuff pretty quickly. Shields just now protect my base. Like I said, now it's I've got everything I need. I've got power, mass in the plenty. I can pretty much produce what I wanted. So we're just gonna throw down a couple more of these. Then I want a tech 3 power and a tech 3 station. Tech 3 gunships are amazing for Aeon, they'll destroy anything. Computers do the editing. So I've got plenty of 10-3 power now. I'm plus 196 on mass. A lot of nice spider bots. They really do the damage. Clean that mass. Gunships there are plenty. So the first RAS commander's out now, and he will now just passively pass me mass and power. As you can see, I've got up from 196 to 207 just grabbing him. So a very, very handy little commander. Gonna circle some spy planes around the blue, even though I know what they've got anyway. More shields. Mass is coming back in again now nicely. Pretty little base building. Make sure your commander's always well under a shield. You don't want any friends sneaking by with gunships, bombers, and all that niceness. Have my second Raz soon as commander. As soon as he's built, I'm going to start building my first experimental. The Galactic Colossus. Mass has jumped up with the second one to 218. Spending a lot of mass now. Oh, it's over with. The red just got set up. And there we are. So now we can see the scores and the mass curves. There's a lot of nice metrics in this game to follow if you're a bit of a data person or you're a bit of a numbers person. This game gives you plenty of that on the back of it. Could have finished it so much sooner, but again, just wanted to get the feel of the game again, not having to play it in a while. Yeah, hope you got something out of that, and I would really like some tips. Obviously, I want to get better. I've got some friends that I really want to beat at some point. Yeah, I'm going to leave the stream there. Thank you very much for watching.